Well, I want to first off thank Adelino and the leadership team at Virtual Educa for the opportunity to be with you today and share Ontario and Canada's response as we emerge from the great economic and health difficulty of COVID-19. Obviously, with the disruption on the horizon in our economy and our labor market, it will require innovation and change within our education system, and we are driving that every step of the way. I'm very proud that under our government, we have changed and improved the elementary math curriculum for the first time in 15 years in this province, with a real emphasis on ensuring labor market alignment, because like in many countries around the industrialized world, we have a high rate of youth unemployment. Our aim is to reduce that by giving young people skill sets that they could use in life, but most especially in the job market. We will be one of the first provinces to teach coding within our country. Likewise, financial literacy all the way in the earliest years of grade one. Computational skills, an emphasis on social-emotional learning, and of course, a greater emphasis on learning household economics. This is going to make a difference as our young people merge in what is an increasingly competitive global marketplace. In addition, we have invested more money in technology, in broadband expansion, to make sure that online learning and the benefits of virtual learning can be appreciated and benefited in all communities of the province of Ontario, a large geographic region by any standard, but we're making sure the investments are put in place by working with and leveraging the private sector to get more connectivity to more young people in more regions in remote parts of our province. And that is a success, and it's a partnership driven by synergies and cooperation with the private sector, working with the public sector. We've also worked to ensure that more technology, specifically Chromebooks and iPads, are distributed to those low-income communities and for students at risk. And that's why we put additional money in place and funding in place to achieve that end, to liberalize access to learning online and the benefits of live synchronous learning. We've also, part of our program, put an emphasis on synchronous learning, on that live, dynamic, face-to-face experience where students get that community and likewise they get to learn from each other led by their teacher. And we will standardize that process as a lessons learned from the past months during our closure period to again ensure that all students get that a positive, defensible experience led by an Ontario certified teacher learning Ontario curriculum, which obviously will provide pedagogical benefits for these young people. We really believe that when it comes to learning in this province, we've got to make sure that our curriculum is aligned with our labor market needs. When we launch new curriculum development, which we will be doing rather ambitiously in our province, we're going to make sure that for the first time, we continue to have the public and private sectors, labor, business, nonprofit, all coming together to provide an analysis, an overview of the development of our curriculum, because we want to make sure that when young people are learning in schools, in elementary and secondary, and throughout life, that they can apply that skill set and help them ultimately get a good job. And so that's the aspiration for our focus. We've also emphasized STEM education as a cornerstone of Ontario's curriculum. We want Ontario to be, and we are working hard to develop Ontario as a STEM leader in the world, with an emphasis on specialized teaching in mathematics, likewise in science, technology, and engineering. We want to see more young women entering these trades, with a emphasis on the skilled trades as well, where we have less than 5% of women in the skilled trades, notwithstanding the dramatic shortage of workers in the country. We will need more young people to enter these high-paying, often entrepreneurial, and increasingly complex jobs. And so we put a plan in place to incent more young people to do that. There's many things we're doing in Ontario. We're looking to the world for continued collaboration and inspiration. We're grateful for the work you are doing, really elevating our conscience and our focus on ensuring students have a competitive advantage. It's something we share in Ontario. I wish you well. Stay safe.